Hello everyone, welcome to our today's session. In this session, we are going to learn some basic concepts on electronics. So before starting our lessons, if you are new to our channel, please subscribe to stay updated with our latest videos. Now let's start. So today let's learn what are conductors, insulators and semiconductors. So tell me, what do you mean by conduct? So conduct means transferring of something. Then what are conductors? Yes, the materials that conduct or transfer of electricity are known as the electrical conductors. So there are so many examples such as silver, gold, copper, aluminium, mercury, iron, seawater, etc. So instead we can say that all metals conduct electricity. Now you have a question, why metals conduct electricity? Yes, this is because the electrons inside the metals are relatively free to move. So when electricity is passed through metals, electrons carry electricity and spread it over the metal. So the mobility of the electron is the main reason why metals conduct electricity. Okay, now let's see what are insulators. This is opposite to the conductors. If the materials that do not conduct electricity, that are known as insulators. Glass, plastic, ceramic, rubber, wood, wool, coke are some of the examples for insulators. We know that metals are conductors. Likewise, non-metallic solids are good insulators. Why these non-metals do not conduct electricity? Yes, because in non-metal elements, the electrons held much more tightly and there are few electrons that are free to move. So, this does not conduct electricity. So now we have an idea on conductors and insulators. Now let's see what are semiconductors. So semiconductors are materials in between conductors and insulators. So it conducts small amount of electricity. And most commonly used semiconductor materials in electronic is the silicon. The elements that belong to fourth group in the periodic table shows this property in their crystalline form. So metalloids are semiconductors. Depending on the structures, properties and etc., the semiconductors can be divided into two as intrinsic semiconductors and the extrinsic semiconductors. So firstly, let's understand what are intrinsic semiconductors. What do you mean intrinsic? It means in its purest form, which means by the nature of their existence. So when we consider a single silicon atom, they have four valence electrons orbiting in its outermost shell. So you know, an atom needs total number of 8 electrons in its outermost shell to become stable. So silicon atom has already 4 valence electrons and it requires additional 4 electrons to become stable. Therefore, it shares its electrons with the neighboring atom. So every silicon atom will get 8 electrons in its outermost shell. And it forms a crystalline structure. Then all these atoms set up a bond with each other and it is called as the covalent bond. These covalent bonds are so strong. So therefore the electrons fail to break this bond at 0 Kelvin. So when the temperature increases, what happens? Yes, The electrons absorbs the heat energy and it is able to break the bond. Once the bond is broken, the electron becomes free to carry the current. Then we get a deficiency of electrons in the structure. So it forms an empty space. That is called as the hole. Then we consider the holes as to be positive charge and electrons is the negative charge. As there is an empty space, the neighboring electrons get attracted towards this hole and fill this space. Then that space becomes empty. So this process will continue entire structure in the random manner. Now let's move on to the extrinsic semiconductors. So let's see first how it differs from intrinsic. So we know that intrinsic is a pure form of semiconductor. Then if we add impurities to the intrinsic, it is known as the extrinsic semiconductors. Extrinsic semiconductors are two types. Those are N-type and P-type. We called N-type as the pentavalent and P-type as trivalent. Pentavalent means it has 5 electrons in the outermost shell. And trivalent means it has 3 electrons in the outermost shell. So the group 5 elements such as phosphorus, arsenic, antimony comes under pentavalent. And group 3 elements such as boron, gallium, indium comes under trivalent. And also you have to know that process of adding impurities to the semiconductor is called as the doping. Now let's see what is a P-type semiconductor. If silicon, which is an intrinsic semiconductor, is doped with an element in group 3 such as boron. We know that boron has 3 electrons in its outermost shell. So here the 3 electrons of boron will form 3 bonds with silicon. But silicon has 4 valence electrons. So in the 4th bond of silicon, there will be 1 empty space. Here the each boron electron accept 1 electron to fill the room. So that is why it is called as the acceptor. And also adding of impurity will provide millions of holes. Therefore, the number of holes generated in this structure dominate the electrons. So the holes concentration is greater than that of the electron concentration. So this structure is called the P-type structure. So now let's move to our second type, extrinsic semiconductor. Here the pentavalent elements, or we call group 5 elements, are doped to an intrinsic semiconductor such as silicon. So let's consider antimony as an example. It has 5 valence electrons in its outermost shell. So here the antimony acquire 4 electrons from the nearby silicon atoms to get its outermost shell as the 8. But silicon has only 4 electrons in its outermost shell. What happens? In this process, one of the 5 electrons is left behind without taking part in the forming of the bond. So this electron has the opportunity to move freely in the latex. So here the electrons that is left behind increases the conductivity of the latex. And since the electrons are donated to the latex by this antimony, these are known as donors. And also as the negatively charged electrons are introduced to the latex as the charge carriers, these semiconductors are known as the N-type semiconductors. So let's learn the next part in the next session. Thank you, everyone.